So, hello everybody. Welcome to the second lecture on TLM. So, last time we have understood that TLM was a level of modeling which was at a higher abstraction level from RTL, and it originated from the need to improve the productivity of SoC design with the increasing complexities. So, TLM as a style of modeling in digital systems originated with a focus on external function behavior of each block and the inter-block communication without excessive implementation details required. The function stands here for the behavior or the operation of each building block described in the high abstraction level with the help of variables, arithmetic operations and the subroutine calls. So, with the help of the objects, references and the data structures, we could actually explain the functionality of any block without going into the details of the actual signals, the data types, number of signals and the hardware implementation of that particular block. So, TLM does not directly handle signals and registers, though the variables, they may be correlated to signal values which will be required for the required actually in the RTL design. So TLM this style which can be built as soon as the architectural specification is available. That is, we need to understand. So for the SoC design was model of computation and model of architecture. So, when the model of architecture is available and the functional the application model of computation is available, so it was that early that your TLM could be started in the design process. Okay. So, then we also understood the difference between the RTL and the TLM. So, it enables modeling of the each component independently at different levels of abstraction. So, once verified, it becomes a reference model for the low-level implementations. So, it is also facilitating your path from the high-level implementation to the low-level implementation. So, it starts at the functional level and it can bridge between the high-level to low-level, that is micro-level architecture, micro-architecture level design, okay? Then we come to the types of TLM. So, TLM, it can be either untimed TLM or it can be timed TLM. When it is untimed TLM, it is also referred to as PV or the programmer's view. In this case, there is no timing detail which is there. So, no timestamps they are available or they are recorded. So, the ordering of the transactions which are occurring to carry out a particular function or a task, that is accurate and that is available. Okay, but then there is no information on time. So, clock is not needed in this and no information related to the micro architecture, it is there. So, untimed TLMs, they are generally useful for early stage prototyping. Okay, then we come to us timed TLMs. So, as the name suggests, in the timed TLM, or also known as the programmer's view plus timing. So, timing details are added. Typically, every TLM or every transaction has a start and the end time. Okay. So, it is more closer to the real-time behavior of the system. Okay, and further this TLM can be a loosely timed TLM or it can be a approximately timed TLM or simply a TLM, timed TLM. So, when I talk about loosely timed TLM, this implies that number of transactions that is determined, that is for carrying out a particular function, the number of transactions which are required, that is known. But the duration is known, but the order that is not fixed. Okay. Whereas in case of the approximately timed TLM, both the number and the order of transactions is accurate. So timed transactions with each transaction having a fixed start time, fixed end time, and how many number of transactions required, plus in what order those transactions they are implemented, they are actually referred to as timed TLM or approximately timed TLM. Okay. Further, the implementation can be either in the annotated form or in the standalone form. So we are not going to go into those kind of details. So programmers view accurate modeling. In this, the contents of the visible memory and registers is as per the real hardware, but timing may be inaccurate or it may not be included, and other registers or the combinational nets are not designated, okay, as they may be in actual used. Okay, whereas if the timing is added, then it is more at the microarchitecture level using cycle accurate models to complete the timing detail. So it means that untimed TLMs, they can be used early in the process, whereas time TLM, they require some amount of information to determine that, okay, if let's say if there is a request for DMA access, so if a request is being sent, it has to be looked for, or that acknowledgement has to be looked for in a limited time frame. So that is there, okay. But other it was untimed TLM, it is only that there is a request and there is acknowledgement if the access is granted, simply three signals. But in that case, we have first the request has to be sent, then the acknowledgement has to be sent, and that is limited. Okay, it is not that you are going to keep waiting for 10 seconds. So the time frame is given to you. So that is the difference. Okay. So let's come to the advantages of TLM. So it's just summarizing what we had learned. So in this, as we have learned, as we are moving at the course level of defining the model with reference to the hardware details, the accuracy, as you move to the higher level from transistor or the circuit towards the system, we know that the simulation accuracy decreases. Okay, because a lot of approximations are there, a lot of assumptions are there, and the determining at upper level may lead to some variations in the actual circuit which may not be reflected or actually be effectively modeled. But in case of TLM, this is the advantage that there is no loss of accuracy. So simulation, though it becomes fast, speed is good. Even the speed of developing the model is fast because not much of complexity is there. Okay, so unnecessary details are ignored. Abstraction, it is higher than functional level, so it creates a clear and a seamless path from the customer requirements to the detailed hardware and software specification. So I told you, so it is starting with the requirements or the specifications in the terms of application as it should work, and then with the help of cycle accurate models, it can move down to or mapped to RTL model, so it can bridge between the functionality and the actual microarchitecture details. So it helps explore the system architecture with initial hardware software partition, CPU selection, and bus architecture. So definitely model of architecture is there, and for specifying the model of computation, it helps in the exploration. So it provides early software developing environment, and it definitely supports co-design and co-verification because it happens at the early stage. So it is taking software along with the hardware. RTL is purely hardware. Then it provides the golden model for the hardware. I think it is the same point reiterated. It is able to bridge to the RTL level. Then hybrid abstraction level modeling is also possible, so that if the details are available, each of the module can be refined incrementally. So that is another very good approach, where both RTL and TLM can be applied in the process of refining from high level towards the low level representation. And next is, it gives the object in the image. And that is very, very important, because as I told you, if two blocks A and B, they are going to communicate, so there is not much of details into which we need to go. It is only that block A wants to communicate with block B. If it requires certain data, it will make a request, and B has to respond with the access information to that request. Okay, so we are independent of the objects which are required. Okay, so this is the typical place of TLM in SOC design flow. So rest of the flow we are already familiar with. So first, specifications are there, model which is at a functional level, that is rather higher than the functional level, it is developed with reference to hardware and software. And in this model development, it is TLM which is used. Okay, so TLMs can be used for both hardware and software development, and they help in the process of design space exploration using MoA and MoCs, as we've already learned in design space exploration. And after, once the model is finalized, the co-design approach that begins with software and hardware being independently developed, simulated, co-simulated rather I should say, and co-verified, and eventually they are integrated to test the complete system and verifying and testing the functionality, and if it is all fine, then it goes for fabrication. So here we have understood what is the significance, or where does TLM modeling fall in the SOC design flow. Okay, so with this we end this lecture on TLM. So just trying to wind it up, that in essence TLM, it abstracts away the RTL details and models the functionality and communication among the system modules. Communication is seen as the exchange of transactions. So communication, it is seen as the exchange of transactions between the architectural resources. As a result, it proves to be much faster than RTL models and the cycle accurate models. It is implemented using the high level programming languages that are capable of developing not only the plain software program, but also are capable of modeling the hardware at the conceptual level without describing the real implementations. The potential candidates which are used for TLM are System C, Spec C, HPascal, System Verilog, and Hardware C. System C 2.0 is quite popular in TLM modeling, and you can find a number of references in the research also. So though different languages are available, System C is one of the most popular ones which is being used widely. So with this, we come to end our lecture on TLM, and hope we are clear about what is it. Thank you so much.